Hey guys, today I will present my updated post-production process with a touch of AI. We'll go from this image to this in no time. This video is sponsored by ASUS and Intel, more on that later. I always start my post-production process in the Corona frame buffer. The image we use comes from my new visualization course. Here I don't do much. I will add highlight compression to reduce to bright areas. I will move it to the top, below the exposure layer, and set the value to 2. I will add the filmic layer and increase the rich shadows option. Not too much. I will also desaturate the image a bit. I always find it too saturated with the default settings. Finally, I will add a LUT from my library. This one is nice. Again, not too much. Maybe I will make it brighter as well. Of course, you need a powerful machine to quickly create renders like this one. Now let me tell you about my new laptop, ASUS ProArt Studiobook 16 OLED. Spoiler alert, just found the perfect machine for me. It has an extraordinary performance, Intel Core i9-3980HX processor and NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4070 laptop GPU. It's way faster than our current PC setup. Before, we used to take our 2 PCs and 4 monitors for longer trips, which was a nightmare. Now, we can just pack one bag and go wherever we want. What a time to be alive! Check out the link in the description to find out more about this laptop and Intel processor. Now, let's save render elements. We'll be using the wire color and the alpha passes. Let's open Photoshop. We have to open the main image. Let's choose to load alpha channel data as an alpha channel. This way, we'll have the whole image. Here we go. Double-click on the layer to unlock it. Then, let's go to the Channels tab. Here is our alpha channel. The red parts will not be selected. The glass part will be partially selected. Click the channel while holding the Ctrl key to select it. Let's turn the channel off and go back to the Layers tab. Click here to add a mask. Now you can see that the background is transparent. As I mentioned before, you can see the glass a bit. Lastly, I will convert the mode to 16-bit channel, so we are able to use all the adjustment layers. Now, let's add the background image. I will make it a bit smaller and position it in the right place. Let's move it below the render. Here is fine. We need a bit more sky. Not a problem. Let's use AI. Let's select this area. Make sure a bit of the image is selected and click Generative Fill. We don't need any prompt. Here are the three options. I like this one. I will collapse these layers together as I won't need to edit them later. This cloud is a bit annoying actually. Let's remove it. I will use the removal tool. We just have to paint over the elements we want to remove. Great, we have to make it way brighter though. We can add the brightness contrast adjustment here below the main image. In this case, it will work only on the layers below it. The laptop screen is also very impressive. It is ASUS Lumina OLED, 16-inch, 3.2K, 120Hz OLED display. It has a 16 to 10 aspect ratio, so you have a bit of extra room on the vertical end. It is a touch display, which is super handy. I also desaturated it a bit and added a white color on top, with a lower opacity. The outside part of the render is a bit too bright in my opinion. Let me show you what I do in this situation. I go back to the 3ds Max and lower the exposure a bit. Save the file and place it in Photoshop. Here it is. Let's add a mask with the Alt key pressed. This way the mask will be black, nothing will be visible. Now, we can paint the areas we want to include with the white brush. My favorite feature of this laptop is the ASUS Dial, which is perfect for Photoshop work. With just one click, I can access all the useful features. We can control the brush size, for example, which will make the work way faster. It's especially great when you work on the go without the mouse. Additionally, we can paint over the touchpad with the ASUS Pen 2.0, which is included in the box. As I said, the perfect laptop for me. We can customize the ASUS Dial in the ProArt Creator Hub. We can create a custom dial for 3ds Max, for example. Now it looks way better. I will group the layers so the file is cleaner. I will go back to 3ds Max one last time and create a version with less contrast. Let's turn off the filming layer and lower the contrast. Save the file and place it in Photoshop. Again, I will create a black mask and with the use of the white brush, I will paint the areas where I want less contrast. I am very happy with that. Next, we can add more adjustments on top of everything. I will start with curves. The S-shaped curve will add a contrast to the image. I will paint out some areas with black, where I don't want to have an effect. Next, I will add a vignetting effect. I will select everything with the Ctrl plus A shortcut, then make the selection smaller. Next, I will use the Shift plus F6 shortcut to access the feather selection tool. I usually go with 1/10 of the longer size of the image, so 500 pixels for a 5K render. I will add curves again and make it brighter. You can see it works only in the center of the image. I will duplicate the layer using the Ctrl plus G shortcut and invert the mask using the Ctrl plus I shortcut so it works only on edges. I will make it darker. Lastly, I darken the bottom of the image a bit more. It will help with the composition. I use a gradient for the mask. Have to invert it though. Great, let me show you another trick. We'll use the wire color pass to select only the sofa. I use the magic wand tool and check the contiguous option to select the parts which are not connected as well. I will make some changes to the color. Make it more red. To use the same mask again, just click with the Ctrl pressed. Here is the selection. I use the curves now. Here we can divide it into three parts. Highlights, middle tones, and shadows. I will make just the shadow darker without touching the brighter parts. Awesome! Let's group everything together. Now, the AI part. Let's turn off adjustments. This way, they will not affect the AI-generated parts. I will start with the removal tool to clean out some parts of the floor and some other elements. Let's uncheck the remove after each stroke option. This way, we can paint everything first and then generate the result. Click here when you are done. Way better! Now let's replace the plants. Plant models, even if they are great, will always look a bit fake to the human eye. AI is a great tool to fix this. I will select it with the lasso tool. Make sure to leave a bit of plant at the bottom. This time I will use the prompt, pampas grass. Otherwise, Photoshop would remove it probably. And just like that, here are our three options. I will go with this one. In the course, I go over every element, but here I will not show you all the elements, as the logic is very similar and I don't want to make this video too long. I will just go over this example as it's very tricky. Let's select the blanket using the lasso tool and click Generative Fill. I will use the prompt, Mongolian fur blanket. Let's generate. It took me a lot of trials to find a nice blanket. I cut the trial and error parts from the video. Here is the one I really like. We have an issue with the chair and table though. It's different from the original. To fix this, let's copy the original render on top and remove the mask. Then select the chair and table using the wire pass. And add the mask to the render. I will select the parts I want to remove and generate fill again. This time without any prompt. Way better, but still, some parts are extended. I will use the stamp tool and remove them manually. First, you sample the area with the Alt key pressed, and then you can paint using this sample. And here it is. Perfect. Look what we've done. Here is the before and after. Here you can check my new visualization course and my other YouTube videos. Check out the link in the description to find out more about this laptop and Intel processor.